It's national meets regional. Welcome to Sidewalks Entertainment, the long-running celebrity, music, and art series. Join us now for an exciting new path to celebrity interviews, music, rising talents, much, much more.
Our guest today, you might remember from the television home design show, Trading Spaces. The series impacted the home renovation arena, and they are back at it again, reuniting with an all-new Trading Spaces. I'd like to welcome the OG, original, beloved host, Paige Davis and Ty Pennington to Sidewalks. Thanks, you guys, for being here.
Thanks for having us. We're back.
We're back. Oh, my God, you guys. We are so excited about you guys returning to Trading Spaces. But before we go back to that, I actually wanted to get to know a little bit about your beginnings briefly, starting with Paige. Your passion was actually in acting. Growing up, you did a lot of musical theater and dancing.
Yeah.
When did this all start?
All the beginnings of my career were musical theater and Broadway and dancing. And I went back to that when Trading Spaces went off the air. I did host other home shows. I hosted a show called Home Made Simple. I hosted a show called Home and Family. So I was in that genre for a while. But all the while, I was doing a lot more theater and going back to my roots.
And when we have a dance off, she usually wins.
Not always, though.
Yeah, it's true. But I do a donkey kick that's pretty amazing. But it's only under certain conditions.
Yeah, that's what I meant. Yeah,
I can imagine you guys both having a dance challenge. Actually, going to you, Ty, you started out as a model, then as a set designer for movies. Is that correct?
Well, a model's a big term for what I did. I mean, I looked like I was 12 for most of my life, but yes, I ended up going to Japan because I was asked to go, and I was like, why? And they're like, you're going to make money. I said, okay, I'll try it. So, but I didn't do well. I mean, let's just say, like, I couldn't make a living at that, but it led to me being comfortable in front of the camera. And then I ended up getting a lot of commercials, and I realized later in life what I became. People were hiring me because I made other people comfortable on camera. So in many ways, I was a fluffer, and I still am, which is just a wonderful thought. So I just, I make people look great on camera. That's really what my gift is.
Yeah. You guys definitely have the personality, and so it makes sense that you guys are both on Trading Spaces. Now, for both of you, how did you guys get the part to be in Trading Spaces? Was it like an audition process for you guys?
Yeah.
You know, when I auditioned with Ty Pennington. He was already on the show.
Yeah.
And he was brought in to...
Yeah, but we knew that Paige really sort of stood out as a really... a very perky, fun, happy personality, which she still has. And honestly, after hosting several shows myself, I realized how good at what she does she really is. For me, when I ended up on the show, I was actually, I had to go through this audition with Frank. And I remember, I'll never forget this. So all these really tall, like good-looking carpenter guys who were standing in line to go audition, I went out there and Frank asked me to build him a box. And he was wanting a flower box. And I ended up measuring his height because I was going to start building him a coffin. And the cameraman realized I was going to build him a coffin and started laughing. And I think that's when they realized we probably had a good chemistry. And that's really what the show is about. The chemistry, I think, with all the other talent, we just really are like a family. And it hasn't changed at all. We have a lot of fun with each other. And we have fun creating like a very amazing room. Whether you like it or not is, you know, still up for grabs. But we have fun with the process. And I think the homeowners have a lot of fun too.
And I think the viewing audience can see that. And I've never met a homeowner, even one who was unhappy with the room in the end, who wasn't still thrilled to have had the experience of Trading Spaces.
You know what? I was going to ask you guys that, Paige, like, or Ty, like, did you ever go into that situation where someone was like, I don't know about this? I mean, they're just like, this isn't going to work.
That happened all the time. And, you know, it happens through the 2 days as well, where you have neighbors, you know, push back with the designer. They're not going to like it. We don't want to do it. I don't want to do it. They're going to hate it. And then the homeowners return to the room and they love it. So you can never really necessarily predict. There were times when I thought for sure homeowners were going to hate something. I'm like, oh gosh, I don't even want to reveal this to them. And then they love it. So...
But I love that. I love the jeopardy of not knowing. You know, that's my favorite part.
Hildy has been with Trading Spaces from the start and is known for her unique take on design.
No.
Oh, my God.
It's feathers.
Oh. You know, when we were 35, back when we did this, we thought we were being completely idiotic.
Doug also started with season one, and he is a designer who is constantly willing to take risks.
Open your eyes and see your new bedroom. Oh my gosh!
Hell.
These two crazy kids put the fun in dysfunctional dynamic duo.
This is like riding a bike. I feel that we just did this yesterday.
Yeah. More like a unicycle, but sure.
Oh man, you found it. Where was it?
In a bunch of cobwebs.
Oh, look at that.
And of course, we have building brothers. Ty Pennington and Carter Osterhaus are dusting off their drills and they're raring to go.
Let's do this.
Oh, damn. Here we go. What the?
This is so exciting. This is my first episode back after a 10-year hiatus. I'm so happy to have you guys as my homeowners. Woo-hoo. You are amazing. Give it up for the homeowners.
Do you guys think it would ever actually return and that you guys would be back hosting on the show and being a part of the show?
I didn't think it that it necessarily so would. I do know that the fans were asking for it.
I never really even thought about it. It's funny.
Yeah.
But the moment the question was asked, my first thought was, well, if they do it, make sure they do it right, because I really have a strong, special feeling about the show, because it is an original. It's an OG. Like, it's one of those things that, and I think its format is so special and works so well, considering a lot of the other shows out there that really make everything look really nice and beautiful all the time and everybody loves it. This is one of those shows that isn't like that. I mean, you really don't know what the ending is going to be till you really see that reaction. And I think what's so great about it is it's ever changing. Like,
there's jeopardy, and also every room looks completely different. You know, you were saying like a variety pack of designers.
Yeah.
You just, on every episode, the rooms look radically different from each other and different from each episode. You just never know what something's going
to. And they're also competitive. They're trying to outdo their last room too. So you never know, like what's going to happen.
Yeah, and that's the one thing about you guys is that you guys are always challenging, you know, challenging each other. I love that. And also with humor in the show. And I'm assuming you're keeping this in the whole new Trading Spaces.
Oh, yeah.
It's kind of hard to filter out.
Yeah, with you guys, yeah. Now for you guys, since your days on the original Trading Spaces until now, how has it changed your life?
Oh, wow. Well,
that's
a deep one. It's funny. I tell people, people have asked me questions. Like, the question I get all the time is, like, how'd you become, like, you know, a famous carpenter? And I was like, that's a really good question. After the success of Trading Spaces, my friends would be like, dude, how did you get a job being you? And I'm like, well, I guess I was qualified. But because, honestly, that's really what I did. I built things and then I had a job doing it, but I just never did it for a TV show. But there was a moment, like, I think it was the third season or maybe the second season of Trading Spaces, that the crowd started to really gather out in the cul-de-sacs. And then one time, like, it was, like, bigger than I'd ever seen it, and I had to leave on it with a trash can over my head, and I was like, my God, so this is what being, you know, famous looks like and smells like. But, I don't know, you know, life, but it went on, like I said, this show really started a huge, you know, sort of ball of momentum for all of us in the entertainment industry, and, like, I went on to do amazing shows where we changed lives, et cetera. So, yeah, it was the catapult that we were actually stoked to go back to, because it was so much fun. And honestly, it's real, because it really is who we are as people. And it's fun to work with one another and do some fun projects that if it's too much, we can say to the person, like, there's no way I'm doing this for you. This is, you know, or you know what I mean? Like, we can actually be real. And it's an awesome experience.
That's right. Well, you guys, we're so excited to have you guys back. Wish we could talk to you longer, but, you know, come to San Francisco if you can to do your next project.
Yes.
Will do. Will do, Veronica. Thank you.
All right, Paige. All right, Ty. Thank you so much. Good luck to you and much continued success. We'll see you soon. Thanks to our guests, Paige Davis and Ty Pennington, for that interview. You can catch the all-new Trading Spaces on TLC.
For more full-length celebrity interviews, visit SidewalksTV.com.